Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to recreate the glass prism effect in the poster for the Netflix series Ripley, which will work using any photos you like. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to create the basic shapes that will form our prism effect. To do this, click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. We'll fill it with white, but before we do, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. If they're inverted, press X. Since white is our background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a narrow rectangular selection over the left side. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Gradient. Photoshop automatically makes a layer mask of the selection next to the gradient. Press and hold the Shift key as you rotate the angle counterclockwise until it snaps to minus 180 degrees. The style is linear. Open the gradient list of presets and open Basics. Click the black to white preset. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click just below the gradient bar to create a new stop. For its location, type in 80. Click the color box to open the color picker and pick white. Then click OK. Click the lower right stop, the color box, and pick black. Then click OK on all three windows to close them. We'll make a copy of the gradient by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Open your Move tool and go to View. If Snap isn't checked, click it to activate it. Press and hold the Shift key as you drag the copy over until it snaps to the edge of the gradient to its left. Press the right arrow key on your keyboard 3 times to move the gradient copy 3 pixels to the right. Make a copy of this gradient, press and hold the Shift key, and drag this gradient until it snaps to the gradient to its left. Repeat the same steps a few more times. To speed up the process, Shift-click the bottom gradient to make all the gradients active, and press Ctrl or Command J to make copies of all of them. Press and hold the Shift key again as you drag the group copy to the right and snap it to the edge of the other gradients. Continue making copies and dragging them over until they fill your document. Make the top gradient active, scroll down to the bottom gradient, and Shift-click it to make all the gradients active. We'll place them into a folder by pressing Ctrl or Command G. Go to File and Save a Copy. Save it to your desktop for easy access, and let's name it Glass Prism. Save it as a Photoshop PSD file and click Save. If you see this message, just click OK. Since we saved the columns of the gradients as a PSD file on our desktop, we can delete it from our Layers panel. Shift-click the white layer to make it active as well, and click the trash can icon to delete them. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Distort folder and click Glass. Click this icon and click Load Texture. Click the Glass Prism PSD file on your desktop, then click Open. The distortion amount determines the intensity of the prism effect. For this image, I'll make it 16. The smoothness controls the smoothness or sharpness of the prism's edge. I'll make it 1. The scaling controls the size of the prism. I'll make it 100%. If you see any distortions on your image, open the rectangular marquee tool and drag it over the distortion. Go to Edit and Generative Fill. Click Generate. Photoshop's AI technology analyzes our image and provides 3 variations of the filled area. Pick one of them and press Ctrl or Command E to merge it with your image. If you want to make it black and white, click the adjustment layer icon and simply click black and white. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.